Welcome back to the show. Great to have your company. Aged care is getting its biggest shake-up in a generation. The government striking a deal with the coalition that will see self-funded retirees pay more and increase support for older Australians choosing to stay at home.
To discuss, let's bring in the Chief Executive of COTA, Patricia Sparrow, in Melbourne now. Patricia, thanks for your time this morning. Now, we know reform has been much needed in this sector. These changes have been described as the biggest improvement to aged care in 30 years. Do you agree?
Good morning. Look, there's really significant reform in this package and really important reform. We know that most older people want to stay living at home and the government's investing so that people can. And of course, the Aged Care Act that was introduced into Parliament yesterday is the response to the number one recommendation from the Royal Commission into the quality and safety of aged care, which is that the Act be based on rights and focus on older people rather than on the funding arrangements between government and service providers. And this Act does that.
All right, Patricia. As you know, I'm not the sharpest tool in the shed, but I watched the announcement yesterday and the stories on Nine with Charles last night, and I found some of it, the detail of it, a lot. And I watched it with Mum, and Mum didn't quite understand it all. Is that going to be part of your issue here?
Look, the detail is a lot, and I do understand people find it confusing. It's a lot because it's based on your income and your assets, but also on the services that you receive. So we do have to find ways of being able to talk about this in a way that's more understandable for people. We're still analysing all of the detail. We do understand that there will be calculators, etc., for people, so you can put your own situation in and see what that will mean. Also, another good thing here, particularly in home care, is that the pension test will be used. So people who've already been assessed for the pension will have already provided a lot of the information. It should make it more straightforward to work out what it is that you're going to pay.
When will it come into effect? I mean, to Carl's point, there is still a lot that needs to be worked out before the contributions start coming into place and people do start to, I guess, fork out more for their care.
So 1st of July is when new people entering residential or home care will have the new fees regime. But it's really important to know that what government has done is that if you're already in residential care or you're already receiving a home care package or you're on the waiting list and have been approved for a package, these changes to fees won't impact you at all. So it does give time for the new fee regime to settle and it protects people who are currently in the system from paying more.
I think the support at home package is really great in principle. Sarah and I were talking about this before we came on the show today. Is there a concern that it could be rorted in some way?
I think that what government's doing here is trying to, firstly, as we said, acknowledge that people want to live at home. I don't think there can be rorting in the same way, but that's something that we need to look at. There'll be a list of the sorts of services you can have under the package and the sorts of services that you can't. And so I do think that some of the regulation that will come in around support at home will protect more against that. It's also good to see in the support at home package that there'll be more levels of care. So at the moment, you can get four different types of home care packages and, you know, you're kind of chucked into a box, if you like, and you get that amount of money. There will now be eight, so it should be able to be more tailored to you. And at the top end, the funding is more than what you can currently get. So people will get more support at home. Plus, they have two short-term supports for people that have been bugbears, I guess, in the system. So if you've been in hospital and you need a little bit more support to recover and be able to live at home, you'll be able to get 12 weeks rather than 8 weeks of what's called restorative care. And that's really important because people sometimes need more. And if you're in the last 3 years of your life and you want to die at home, which most people do, but unfortunately most people end up in hospital or somewhere else, there's an additional $25,000 that you can access to help you do that. So these are important things that older people have said are important to them.
All right, that's great detail, and we anticipate more as well. Thank you so much. Appreciate it. Well, historic aged care reforms are on the way this morning, with 1.4 million Australians promised more support under a new deal by the government and opposition. To discuss, we're joined by Bill Shorten in Canberra and opposition leader Peter Dutton in Melbourne. Morning, guys. Nice to see you. Billy, to you first up. This is a big deal and might take a little while for us to wrap our heads around it, but it's long overdue.
Yeah, listen, and it's been a lot of work by Minister Annika Wells, and congratulations to the Coalition for working with us on this. It's all about making sure that people in the future in aged care, when they're getting their funding, have got dignity, got support. The first thing also to say to people trying to wrap their head around the detail is they can go to a website, they can get each case study they need, but if you're currently in aged care, there's no change. It's a future proposition. and we are going to be supporting in the future 100% of people's clinical care needs.
It's a good thing both sides working together on this too. Pete, will it hold up when the reforms move through Parliament, or do you anticipate moving for some changes to the legislation?
Well, morning, Carl. Look, we've worked with the government because we think it's in our national interest to do so. We've got an ageing population and we want to make sure that people have dignity in retirement and that they can go into an aged care facility. And as a, you know, for your grandparents, for your parents, you want to know that they're being taken well care of, and you want to make sure that they're getting the support that they require. But it costs money to do that. I think Bill's important point is one that we really should stress, and that is that people that are in the system now, they're grandfathered, so there's no change that applies to those people. And there's a Senate inquiry that will tease out a lot of the detail, and people can have their say in relation to that. But we want to make sure that we've got beds being built, because at the moment we just don't have any infrastructure being built in aged care. We've got an ageing population, early onset dementia, etc., and we have to deal with that.
Still challenges with staffing, but hopefully that is sorted too.
Yep. A once-in-a-generation shake-up. That's what the PM is calling new aged care reforms that will see older Australians fork out more money for their own care. Joining us to discuss today's headlines is ALP National President Wayne Swan and Independent MP Di Lee. Good to see you both.
Good morning.
Di, this has bipartisan support. Do you think the right balance has been struck here?
Look, you know, I think from my perspective, especially for home care, that is quite important because of the whole COVID thing, more people are choosing to stay at home. Yeah. So I think increasing that package for home care is very important. And of course, you know, any improvement, it's an improvement rather than not. In particular, in my community in Fowler, people of non-English speaking background, people are needing that specialist care and that language skills and cultural needs. They can do that at home, and they can bring those care into the home, and it'd be better for those that are aging, you know, gracefully, I suppose.
Yeah, no, absolutely. Wayne, these reforms are much needed, obviously, and everyone welcomes them, I think. I guess with changes like these, we just need assurances in place that the system isn't rorted, and particularly with that home care package, like Di mentioned, you know, there is opportunity there for some people to game the system potentially.
Look, this has been in gridlock for well over a decade. We nearly got to an agreement on this back in 2013 and it fell over. So over the next decade or so, there have been extreme shortages. People have not been able to get into nursing homes. People have not been able to get respite care, let alone get care in the home. So long overdue, a very, very good deal. People who can afford to will pay a bit more, but I think there will be a lot of people out there in the community who have been very worried about what's happening with their aged relatives and what's going to happen in the future. The number of people aged over 65 is going to double into the future.
Yeah.
So the government has finally got ahead of the game on this. I congratulate everyone from Aged Care Minister Wells to the opposition who backed this in. Yeah. It was absolutely essential, and it's a great example of good policy making in a bipartisan way.
But just on that detail, Swanee, I agree with everything you've said, and I think this is very much needed. I'm not saying it's going to be like the NDIS, but are there some lessons to be learned like that kind of scheme so that we don't see that repeated here?
Sure. Well, of course, you know, getting rid of the rorts and the NDIS is absolutely essential, but this is not a new scheme. Part of the problem with the NDIS was it came out of the blue and they were finding their way. We know a lot about aged care. We know how to deal with it. We need to train a lot more people to work in it, but we do have the established systems, and I think people can be assured that it will not be going down the road of the NDIS in the early years.